Hello, good morning. We are going to discuss today about what is called swapping of two variables. This is very frequently carried out exercise in computer science. Swapping means exchanging. Swapping means exchanging. So, where it is frequently used? Say it is used in most of the time what is called as sorting exercises. So when you look at the two variables, let us say a variable A and a variable B, the values present initially in the variables A and B are, A is containing a value 5 and B is a value containing 10. So this is what before swapping. And after you complete the process, it is supposed to contain A, supposed to contain the value 10, and B is supposed to contain the value 5. So this is after swapping. So how the process? There are a number of ways of doing it, but out of which very comfortable one is introducing a third variable, a temporary variable, and perform the sequence. What sequence? First you copy the value of variable A to C. So this, the value present in A is copied to C. So we say in an algorithmic fashion, we write that C is assigned the value of A. And when you see the pictorial representation, you will find that the value present in A is 5 and the value present in C is 5 after your swapping, after your first step. Now, the second step involves copy the value of B to A. See, the B is containing the value 10 and we are just copying. Say, copy the value of B to A. That's what you say. You write A is assigned B. You say that A is assigned B. I mean the value of B has been received into A. The third step involves copying the value of C to B. So as just now you have seen that the value present in C is 5. The value present in C is 5. So the value present in C is copied to B. You say that B receives the value of C. And finally, you observe that A has received the value 10. It's received the value 10 and B has received the value 5. So this is what expected out of our swapping exercise. We said that finally, A should contain 5 and B should receive 5. A should contain 10 and B must receive 5. So this is what your final configuration. So for whatever the language you are going to use, whether it's C, C++, Java, C Sharp or any other language, when you are introducing a third variable, temporary variable, the first step, temporary variable C, the first step is assign C the value of A. Second step, assign A the value of B. The same thing I am writing here, A the value of B. And then, third step, this is the last step where you should write that B receives the value of C. So this is what simply the method of swapping of two variables. If you are simply performing swapping of variables, if you want to do it without using a third variable, however, this works only if the quantities being swapped are numeric values. Only numeric values swapping. So, as I said, supposing A contains a value 5 and B contains value B. Contains a value 10. This is before swapping. So after swapping, you want to have A containing the value 10 and B containing a value 5. So this is what after swapping. Now without using a third variable, without introducing a third variable, So what is the, what you can do is, if you observe here, what you can do is, first what I do is, to A, I add the value present in A and B. So as you know, just now see that the value going to be present in A after this operation, it is going to be present, the value present in A will be 15. However, this is B and it is still holding a value 10 because I have written this first A is A plus B. So this 5 plus 10, it becomes 15. Then as a second step, you can write that, B is, as it's supposed to receive the value 5, I write that B is A minus B. So B is A minus B. So the value present in A is 15, but the value presently present in B is 10. So you know that this will go, and this 15 minus 10, so it becomes actually 15 minus 10, the result will be 5. So this receives the value 5. Now as a third step, you can write that, now you can say that A is, now again you can write that A is A minus B. So the value present in A is now 15. But the value present in B is 5. So it becomes 10. So by performing operations in this way, you will be able to swap the finally the values in, you will be able to swap and finally the value present in A will be 10 and the value present in B will be 5. That is what expected out of our operation of swapping. However, it is not that you can only do the addition and subtraction. You can also do this swapping of exercise without using the third variable, but using different operations instead of addition and subtraction. I will introduce in my next topic on this swapping the other method which is used for swapping of two variables without using a third variable. Thank you.